Hi there guys, welcome to Guitar Interactive and to our quiet room. My name's Tom Quayle and today I've got a review of this diminutive little guitar. This is the Aria ASA 18HN. Now it's designed really, it's a parlor guitar that's designed as a travel guitar or as a beginner guitar. If you wanted to sort of give a smaller person, let's say, a starter guitar, this would do really, really nicely for those with smaller hands. But it's definitely an instrument that can be used as a main guitar if you're doing some traveling, and works very, very nicely indeed. So as usual, let's start at the headstock end, work our way down. Not a complicated guitar in terms of construction. If we start off at the headstock end, we got a mahogany neck and headstock with a slotted headstock design, a particular favorite of mine. Very neatly done. Little contours here are very nice, just as the slots start. Very nicely done inside. The finishing could be a little bit neater in there, but it looks fine. It's very, very functional. Three per side tuners, vintage style, open gears. If I just turn to the side there, you can see the open gears. Looks more like a sort of what you might think of as a classical or nylon string guitar style headstock. I think these look great. Very, very nice design. If I just turn it to the back, maybe you can see the Made in China sticker. These are designed in Nagoya in Japan, but they're made in China. So you've got a nice design team in China working on these for you. And the shape's really cool, actually. Just on those tuners on the side, we've got some nice little flaring across the edges here, which looks really cool. The tuners work very nicely, they're very functional, and unlike a lot of these style of tuners, they're not too stiff and they don't creak. They feel solid and very well made, which is great. Very comfy joint here. Well, it's not a joint really, but just the way it's carved across here, where it actually meets the neck. Very comfortable if you're playing chords down the bottom, nice sort of neck design. The neck itself obviously is very small because it's a travel guitar. Feels very, very comfortable. And you'll notice the shorter scale length with the smaller frets, or spacing between the frets, I should say. In terms of the actual feel of it, there's a slight, I would say, D shape to it. There's a slight sort of, not a ridge, but it's, well, as you say, it's like a D shape. It's not as smooth as a C shape. Supremely comfortable. Even if you've got tiny hands, you'll find this very, very easy to play. The only thing that might throw you off is that scale length might feel a little strange at first, especially if you're playing up this end of the guitar. But for smaller scale length guitars, this is very, very comfortable to play in all regions, I have to say. Obviously, synthetic nuts here. Rosewood fretboard. Let me just show you the back of the neck. There's our mahogany neck again. Entirely mahogany, this guitar. Very, very smooth indeed, just with a light satin finish, so it feels very, very comfortable. And as we move up to the neck joint, very neat indeed. There's no glue sticking out or any kind of wood shavings going on there at all. On the side, hopefully you can see, we've got the dots here. Very neat, just functional. Fretwork's very good. There's no fret sticking out the sides at all, which is totally inexcusable these days. Even at this price range. As we move to the neck itself, to the join of the body again, very neat here. A little bit of kind of finishing that could have been done. There's a little bit of glue sticking out here, but again, at this price range, you can forgive that for sure. You're going for basics here, and if you're traveling with it, you know, you're not going to be too worried about things like that. It's not meant to be totally aesthetically pleasing, although it is a very, I think, a very good looking guitar for the money. Mahogany top. With this kind of, it's like a burnt finish in there. It's obviously a lot cheaper to produce these than it is to put a rosette on there. And actually, I like these. I think they look great, this feature. And you'll find this even on more expensive guitars. So certainly looks the part. A little bit rough around the edges, but again, at this price point, you know, to be expected. I mean, the guitar looks fine, to be honest. Nice grain going along here. Almost a little bit of flame in there, actually, which is nice. We've got a rosewood bridge as well. And the actual saddle looks really great. It's no tuning issues or anything, or intonation issues as we go up the guitar. So that's all good. Plastic pins, but they feel fine. No issues there at all. On the side, there's ever such a light bit of binding around both sides here. And that's just where the wood's being cut, basically. But mahogany sides, again, with that nice grain in, and then a mahogany back. So all mahogany, which is an interesting design choice, but obviously makes construction very easy for the guys at Aria. Okay, so pretty simple guitar. You've got strap button just there. And obviously on the top, they didn't put another strap button because they expect you're going to tie the strap on in the traditional kind of acoustic manner. Although with this kind of guitar, you're more likely to be sat down playing it, to be honest. Hopefully around a campfire. You know, traditional kind of traveler's setup. So, very nicely constructed guitar, plays very nicely. The action is a little high at the nut end, which means that that transfers right the way across the guitar. But again, you could have that setup, just cut the nut slots a little bit deeper to taste, basically. But in terms of the tone, it's a little bit boxy sounding, but the tone is very good in terms of the dynamic range and it's like got a piano mechanistic kind of quality, a very nice bright sound, but because of the nature of the body size, I mean, you can see how small it is, it's got a bit of a boxy sound. Now, Aria have helped that a little bit by making the bout a little bit wider at this end of the guitar. So this is definitely where you want to mic it for the most bass response. But you can't really get away with that, away from that. It's gonna sound a little bit boxy due to the nature of the shape of the body. But I think it sounds pretty impressive and it's got a very nice response. So if you play lightly kind of picked parts, it responds very nicely, and it's actually louder than you would expect, especially if you play quite hard. What is lacking a little bit, and again it's partly down to the size of the body, is a little bit of bass here. There's no thump at all, which you would get from a bigger guitar, but again, you know, you expect that with this kind of a guitar. It's going to work really nicely for traveling, and it'll fit in, you know, the overhead of a guitar, the overhead of a plane, the overhead bins, with absolutely no issue at all. No one's going to stop you with this instrument getting on a plane, which is obviously very useful if you travel a lot. For strumming, again, very responsive. It sounds absolutely fine. So if we strum this G chord, now you can hear that at the end, the reason I let that chord ring for a little bit, as you can hear, it's got very good sustain. So let me show you that one more time. And that's pretty impressive, again, from a guitar this size, and the mahogany's helping with that, and the very solid neck joints, good construction is helping with that a lot. So all in all, not a bad guitar at all, actually. Well constructed. I think it looks pretty cool. I like this design where it's wider at the back end than it is at the front. The little burnt rosette looks good. Very clean fretboard. I like the fact that they've not put any dots on the front. Obviously, we've got the dots on the side for enabling you to locate where you are. Looks the part. I like the slotted headstock. Feels very well made. I would change the action a little bit just by cutting the nut slots a little bit, or maybe just needs a little bit of adjustment on the truss rod, which I guess you can't do. Yes, you can. You can adjust it just here. Internally, all very nice indeed. No issues there at all. Looks really nice on the inside. So definitely recommended if you're looking for a travel guitar, or if you're looking for a first guitar for a child or a smaller person who's going to struggle with a full-size guitar. This is going to really work for them because it sounds good and plays well. So it could be a really good first guitar. Or a good traveling guitar. So that's the Aria ASA 18HN. Hope you've enjoyed the review, guys, and I will see you next time.